we met almost in 1991. We both were classmates. Again, we got married in 2000. She reads my mind. Totally into the depth core, she reads my mind and she know what I need, what, you know, I, my dislikes, my likes. Yeah, I am lucky enough to have a wife like, you know, Naga. But in 2006, somebody said I need to have a family physician in order to get my citizenship. And then, you know, as a part of routine health checkups, he said my urine has a protein leakage and then hematuria, which is a blood in the urine. I have referred to a nephrologist and I was asked to go for a kidney biopsy. So in the kidney biopsy, they found that I have IgA nephritis.
IgA kidney disease is really a disease where your own immune system makes this molecule or protein called IgA. This IgA gets deposited in your kidney and causes a kind of a reaction, inflammation in the kidney that detects the IgA in the kidney and then causes damage to the kidney. With time, that can lead to kidney failure.
We were not aware of that he's having a problem with the IgA nephritis, but we are not very particular about maintaining the dietary things and nutrition. He's not supposed to take too much of protein, and he's not supposed to take too much of potassium as well.
When I meet my nephrologist, then he said, your kidney function is right now at 20%, right? So now start thinking about yourself for the kidney transplantation. I feel like normal. At the same time, not on every daily basis, I feel totally down and myself, and it is, I feel like I don't have energy to even go for a couple of steps.
Mr. Turaga does feel sluggish, and he probably will feel with a functioning kidney, the hope is that he's going to have more energy and actually feel better.
My wife and my brother both were came up front for donating the kidney, and then that's how I was referred to St. Joseph.
Naga is a good candidate as a living kidney donor to her husband because she's gone through all the thorough testing that's required of a donor, and plus she's very motivated. She wants to give her husband the ultimate gift. He's in need of a kidney, and she's healthy and she's able and capable and willing to give him a kidney.
I don't have any kind of fear to go for the surgery, and I feel proud myself that I'm giving kidney to my husband, that it's something, somewhere I'm helping him to, you know, not sharing life, sharing the organs too.